Hello friends, namaste, I'm Bhavna and today I'm making another easy to prepare anytime paneer bhurji recipe. And paneer bhurji is a typical Punjabi way of cooking crumbled paneer with the mix of onion, tomato and sometimes the peppers, the bell peppers. And also you can make the paneer bhurji pie with the leftover paneer bhurji, also called paneer bhurji pilos. So let's start. Today it's going to be Indian style cooking. I'm using the Indian style gas stove here and outdoor. Alright, so on a high temperature first. So I'm going to heat the oil. Add a couple of tablespoon oil. Earlier I showed the video of the paneer bhurji with the gravy in it. Today I'm going to show you the dry version, which is really easy. It doesn't take any effort at all. From the same leftover paneer bhurji, you can again make, you know, you can use the leftover as a, you know, you can make the paneer bhurji pilau or a paneer bhurji pie, and it's very instant. You can just you know, fill it, use the you know, the ready pie crust and then fill it and then bake it, and that way it becomes your appetizer. So the oil is ready and I'm going to add the cumin seeds. So about, you know, I'm going to add the 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds. This, you know, the cumin seeds brings out the real nice flavor to this, you know, the paneer bhurji. So the oil is done and add the cumin seeds. Now I'm going to add the asafoetida hing. And I have this onion here, the finely chopped onion. Give the onion a quick stir. Let the onion get a little bit tender. Bring down the temperature on the low now, or the medium heat. While onion is cooking, I'm going to show how I have the other vegetables here, the tomatoes and the bell peppers. I use both the red and the green, so combination of both. And to garnish with, I have the cilantro, the fresh finely chopped cilantro. And of course, the paneer. This paneer is a crumble paneer. You don't have to cut even, so you can just, you know, you can use the homemade paneer for this particular recipe. If you know, because it doesn't have to be in a you know, very nice shape or very nice pieces. Now the onions are tender a little bit. Just the edges are a little golden brown. So at this time, I'm going to add the peppers, the red and the green. And I'm also going to add the ginger, garlic, and the green chili. Now from the masala, I'm going to add the turmeric powder, coriander powder, just a little bit of red chili because we use the green chili as well, so just a little bit of red chili. And I have this garam masala that I'm going to add later on. For the garam masala, I'm using this Sahi Paneer garam masala. This brings out real nice flavor and the color as well. But you can use any Punjabi garam masala that you have. Now at this time, I'm also going to add the cashews that I have. The kaju. It looks already colorful. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put everything on the side, in the middle. I'm going to add just a little bit of more oil, just a little bit, just to coat. And add the crumbled paneer, just to cook a little bit the crumbled paneer, like that. So I'm going to just cook a little bit. So I'm going to give a stir a little bit again, the paneer. It has got a little bit brown now. So look at the paneer, a little bit brown now. See how it has got brown now here, like that. We just want to cook like that, not too much. All right, so I'm going to mix now everything. So ready to add the tomatoes at this time now. So let the tomatoes cook a little bit and all other vegetables, and then we are done, almost done with our paneer bhurji. Now I'm also ready to add the garam masala that we have. It looks already so nice. So the garam masala, now it's a real smell. The aroma of the garam masala is fantastic. This paneer bhurji goes very well with the rice, roti, naan, paratha. But as I said, you can other than the serving with the rice or roti, you can make as an appetizer. You can make the paneer bhurji pilaus.
Oh yes, don't forget to add salt. Add salt according to your taste.
A quick stir again. So the paneer bhurji is done, and the last thing I'm going to add is the cilantro. So fresh, finely chopped cilantro. And I'm going to turn off the stove now. So ready to take out into the serving plate. On the side, rice, and on the other side, the paneer bhurji. It's a best combination.
On the other side of the paneer bhurji, I'm gonna serve the rice, plain rice. Looks so nice. I can't wait to eat.
So the paneer bhurji is ready. Now, as I said, you can make the paneer bhurji pilau or paneer bhurji triangles. I actually brought the paneer bhurji triangles from the chili paneer triangles that you can make if you have leftover rotis. So I have this pie crust that I'm going to take only because I have only this much leftover. The paneer bhurji. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the four heart shape, the pie crust. So I have this, the cutting board that I'm going to use. All right, so okay, one. You don't have to have the the heart shape or something. You can always make the square or any shape that you are comfortable with. Even round works well as well. So the two, and I'm going to show you even how we can make the triangle out of the leftover roti. So three. So we have same size of four, the heart shapes to make the pillow, the paneer bhurji pillows. All right, so I'm gonna roll this again, put it back into the bag. So the four hearts here we have, and on one, this one. Hopefully this is not overloaded for us. Let's try out. All right, so on top of that, I'm gonna wash my hands. Okay, so on here. And then seal it properly.
Try to make the same size of pie crust.
Now, to seal it properly, you can also use the water. Just spread the water on the edges and then brush with the water. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make actually the design. I have the fork here. With the help of fork, I'm going to make like this. So it's automatically going to seal the edges. So the pillow looks perfect, isn't it? Look at this. I'm going to finish the second one. I'm going to bake this at 350 degrees. But since I have only two of these, the very small ones, so I'm going to just use the oven toaster. I'm going to keep actually at the 400 and ready to pop into the oven toaster oven and let it bake. So the pillows are done and I'm going to take them out. So it takes only about 5 to 8 minutes. Look at this. So the pillows are ready. Another idea out of the roti, the leftover rotis. So I have this roti. You can simply fill in and then roll it out like that. Also with the paneer bhurji, or you can do the triangles to make it more fancy. So just make the triangles. Shape of the filling as well, just a little bit, and then just do like this. And then we have to roast it with the butter. So I'm gonna take this to the tawa. Add the butter into the pan. And then just put the triangle that we prepared, just like that. So the folded side goes down first. Let it get brown first side. So first side is done, so I'm going to turn it over. And let the other side get brown now. Triangle is done. So this is the paneer bhurji triangle. The same way you can make the chili paneer triangles. So make the mixture of a chili paneer with the soy sauce and other Chinese ingredients, and then you can make the chili paneer, and that way you can make the chili paneer triangles. For more options, visit website.
Give it a bite. Delicious. Enjoy.